Hallelujah. Greater is he that is in us than he who's in the world. Thank you for your prayers. We are back online, live here on the Boston Praise Radio and TV Network, Healing Alliance broadcast on our main webpage, www.bostonpraiseradio.tv. Simulcasting on the Roku Television Network on the Boston Praise Radio and TV Network channel. Call 712-432-4402 to hear us audibly via your landline or your cell phone. Call us live on the air, 617-282-0685. 617-282-0685. Love to hear from you. Your song request, your song dedication, your praise report, your prayer request, to ask your question and give your feedback or just to say hello. But at everything that has breath, praise the Lord. The Bible says we have a treasure in an earthen vessel, so that the excellency is of God and not of us. Though we're troubled on every side, Sister Hamilton, we're not distressed. We're not without hope. Though we're perplexed, God's ways are not our ways. His thoughts are not our thoughts. They're high as the heavens are from the earth. But we're not in despair. Again, we are not without hope. We're cast down in a godless society where the spirit of the Antichrist is so pervasive, but we're not destroyed. He's with us always, leading us and guiding us into all truth. Hallelujah. We're persecuted, but we're not forsaken. As he's with us always, leading us and guiding us into all truth. Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in our bodies the dying of the Lord Jesus Christ. So the life of Christ can be made manifest, visible in and through us as we go from faith to faith and strength to strength and glory to glory, that no flesh will glory in the presence of God, as God takes the weak things to confound the strong, foolish things to confound the wise, and the lowly things of this world to bring shame to the proud, that no flesh will glory in the presence of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. With God, nothing is impossible. St. Luke 1:37. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, we bless you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Every good and every perfect gift comes from God, the Father of lights, in whom there is no variableness in turning in him. Hallelujah. It's not even entered into the hearts or the minds of mankind, the good things that God's already prepared for those of us that love him. Hallelujah. God will not forsake the work of his own hand. I'm so grateful. The Lord will perfect that which concerns you and I. Vanessa Bell Armstrong's song is entitled Greater is He. And that scripture, the Bible tells us, greater is he who's in us than he who's in the world. Satan comes but to kill, to steal, and to destroy the life, and the life more abundantly that our eternal Father has already secured for us via the sacrifice of the only begotten Son, Jesus the Christ. Living, he loved us. Dying, he saved us. Buried, he carried our sins far away. As he's conquered hell, death, and the grave, and he rose from the dead. No man took his life, but he laid it down. He is the Lion and the Lamb that was the perfect sacrifice for the sins of all of humanity. But he's coming back as a conquering lion as he returns for his body, for his bride, as the righteous king whose kingdom shall never end. And we who are joint heirs with the King of Kings and kings and priests, as we are intercessors for our people group through our perpetual yes to God, no longer I, but Christ who lives by faith in us, as we perpetually humble ourselves and pray and seek God's face and turn from our respective wicked ways, God will hear from heaven the sacrifices exclusively acceptable to him, which are a broken spirit and a contrite heart. He will forgive our sin and he will heal our land. Before we call, he will answer. While we are yet speaking, he will hear us. It's not about perfecting the illusion, but he wants an authentic, intimate relationship with us that we overcome solely by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimonies, loving out our lives unto death, despising the shame for the joy that's set before us. Like Jesus did, we endure our yes to God. And so going to go to some more music. This is the foundation scripture for the ministry of healing our land and my life. Anita Hamilton, it's 2 Chronicles 7:14. It says, if my people, there's a qualifier for this, though we were preordained and destined before the foundation of the earth was ever even laid to be justified and glorified, there's a qualifier. We must embrace our relationship with Christ. We must allow him to do the work in and through us as we're transformed, changed by the renewing of our minds. We become perpetually to the high priest who can be touched by the feeling of our infirmities, who was tempted in all points as we are, present tense, yet he's the only one who never yielded to the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, or the pride of eye. So hence he exclusively qualifies to be the perfect sacrifice, because without the shedding of blood, there's no remission of sin. So he who knew no sin became sin so we could become righteous. And so through our relationship with him, we're transformed, we're changed, and we recover, and we manifest the parts of the collective body of Christ that he modeled perfectly as the head of that body, as the he is the head of the church, and we are his body as living epistles or letters seen and read of men, as literally stones, as our bodies are the temple of the living God. He is the stone that the builders rejected, has become the head cornerstone of that body of Christ, of that temple of people of God, living stones. I'm so grateful that in him we live, we breathe, we move, and we have our being. And all praise and all glory goes to God. All creation's groaning for the manifestation of the sons of God. That's the mature state of our redemptive nature through our perpetual humbling ourselves and praying and saying, search me, O God, and show me if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me into the way everlasting. The sacrifices exclusively acceptable to God are a broken spirit and a contrite heart. He gifted us with life. He gifted us with all of our talents and abilities and gifts, but they're all to be governed under love that believes all things, that hopes all things, that endures all things, that's patient, that's kind, that does not envy. It's not proud. It does not boast. It's never rude. It's not self-seeking. It's not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrong. It does not delight in evil, but it does rejoice in truth. It always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. It always perseveres. Whether there be prophecies, they will fail. Whether there be tongues, they will cease. Whether we have knowledge, that will vanish away, as we know in part and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect, which is agape love, that which is in part is done away with. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. God is love, and he that loveth not does not know God intimately. Beloved, let us love one another. We want to stand before God on judgment day and hear him say, enter into your rest, my good and my faithful servant. And I don't know about you, but I want to go on the first round, the catching away of the saints. I want to make sure that I'm prepared, be my heart is right before God as he judges the intent of the heart. Man sees the outside, God sees the heart. And if God is for us, he's more than the whole world against us. Again, looks as though we have an internet connection. Says the connection was served to the flash server. Check your connection with the internet. Okay, looks as though we may be having some technical challenges once again. I think I may have to update this software, but we're going to try to press through, and hopefully you can actually see us. Greetings to our sister Hester. I see that she has blessed us with her presence. God bless you, sister Hester. Thank you for being with us and blessing us with your priceless presence, woman of God. Again, you may need to refresh your screen. It looks as though we've gone offline for a moment, and I think we should be back on, God willing. Let's see. Again, we have to press through these technical challenges because the enemy comes but to kill, to steal, and to destroy, be a distraction. We're not going to be distracted by him. We're going to continue to press through in Jesus' name and pray and believe that we will be able to work through these glitches to be able to experience what God wants to do in and through our fellowship time this afternoon. We should be back on now. Once again, refresh your screen. I could see myself on the laptop. So I think we are back once again. Our sister, Anita Hamilton, I thank you for being with us. And we're looking to be able to solidify our sister coming into the studio. So we're working out the logistics in our instant chat room conversation. And she said she would be honored to be a guest. She's not sure what her contribution would be. She says she would enjoy seeing me and requesting prayer support as well. She's basically working on some projects and researching some things as she seeks the Lord's will. Amen. And she says, earlier today, she came across an old song by James Cleveland, and she posted it on Facebook. God is. Oh, yeah, I love that song. Of course I remember that song. I used to love to sing that song when I was a really young boy. And she says, do I remember? Absolutely. So actually, once I play the foundation song for the Ministry of Healing Our Land, If My People, will go to this song that is a blast from the past by the legendary James Cleveland. And the song is God Is. We should, oh, goodness, are we back off again? Let me see what's going on here. Yep, we're back off again. Okay, bear with me, family. We'll work through this. Thank you, Sister Hamilton. We're going to go off for a second. See if we can refresh this browser again. We just got to push through these challenges, family. And you can always call 712-432-4402. God willing, that's a way that you'll be able to hear us consistently. The best way is, of course, our main platform, www.bostonpraiseradio.tv, but it's interfacing with multiple programs, so sometimes we do have some technical challenges. I think we're back now. Let me know if you can see us and you can hear us real time. We should be back on the, yes, he says, yes, it's back up. Praise God. Thank you for your patience. We're going to continue to go through our time of fellowship. Here we go. Daryl Coley, 2 Chronicles 7:14. I'll follow that by God Is from James Cleveland. Waiting to hear from you, your respective song requests, your song dedications, your praise reports, your prayer requests, to ask your question, to give your feedback, or just to say hello. Again, blessings to our sister Hamilton, who's here in the state of Massachusetts in the city of Boston, fellowshipping with us, visiting. She is from Atlanta. She's a member of the New Birth Missionary Baptist Church, where the pastors, our friend and brother, Bishop Eddie Long. She also worships with my own biological firstborn sister, Benita Reddick, and her husband, Kevin Reddick, members of that same church. So we send blessings and greetings to the New Birth Missionary Baptist Church and its family represented in that part of the Vineyard of Atlanta, and grateful for our sisters present, our sister Anita L. Hamilton, as well as my sister Cindy Hester, right from here in the city of Boston, who's always plugged in. Thank you for your consistent support, and each and every person who is tuned in. We love you to life, and God loves you as well. 617-282-0685. That's the number to call live on the air, and we'd love to hear from you again. Your song request, your song dedication, your praise report, your prayer request, to ask your question, to give you feedback, or just to say hello. But let everything that has breath praise the Lord.
If my people who are called by my name, would turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven. I'll hear from heaven. I will forgive. See? He promised.